I mean, it's got its particular art style here. I'm getting the Wheel of Death here. Try that again. So, yeah, I've got chapters 1 to 4. Maybe I'll like finish up with like one chapter a night. Like one chapter for each of these late streams. So, actually, before we do that, hang on. I'm gonna just. Okay. So. Okay, so see, what I want to do is just figure out what to do about, you know, the high encoding issue. So yeah, it's so hang on. Okay, 30 FPS. Okay, advanced general high. Okay. So this isn't gonna take effect for this stream, but next stream should be better. Okay. So we are like the spider. We weave our life and then move along it. We are like the dreamer. We dot yes, but that's it. And the sleeping machine presents. The Dream Machine, Chapter 1. I kinda hope I can full screen it at some point. A game by Anders Gustafsson. Sharing. Well, that's that's. Oh man, I can't full screen it. Okay. Hold on. Well, that doesn't help that much. Okay. So, what can I do here? So, the wreck. The boat has been smashed against that rock. Is that how I ended up here? It's strange that I can't remember something like that. Fishing out might be useful. Forked branch. It's a forked branch jutting out of the sand. Piece of wood. Piece of wood. Piece of wood. Shovel. Okay, so. Forked branch jutting out of the sand. Maybe use the fishing rod with a forked branch. Examine the fishing rod. I've placed the fishing rod on the forked branch. The fish doesn't seem too interested in biting. There's a fish around here? Okay, so what if I dig in the ground here, examine the hole, and a worm. Okay, leave. Okay, yeah, not interested. Okay. Fishing rod is baited with a worm. Okay, reeling in the fish. I have a fish now. I can't bear to skewer the thing. It's alive. Ooh, and a lighter. Killed the fish with a rock. Okay. Then I put that on there. And, okay, hang on. I've got some wood down there. And the lighter. It's changing colors, dude. Alright. Okay, tastes great. What's this? Strange, there's a piece of paper in the belly of the fish. Okay. Examine the map. It's a map of right here. Actually, hold on. That should be like.
Huh.
So, It was a dream. Enter the nursery. Examine the guitar. My old axe. Murder my dreams of becoming a stage musician. Once we're settled in, I'll try to get the music career brewing again. Kitchen. Talk to Alicia. Ah! What the hell is her face? I thought I'd surprise you with breakfast in bed. Well, you're surprising me some way. That's sweet. I know, aren't I sweet? It's almost done. Can you set up the table for us? We don't have a kitchen table. Doesn't have to be a table. Anything square and flat will do for now. Just grab an empty box or something. Of course. You got it. Alright. Got an empty box. Oh, no, wait, over by the windows. Living room, I think? Yeah. Here we go. Have you found something to put the breakfast on? Yeah, I put an empty box over there by the corner. Great, let's eat. Just sit down and I'll bring us the breakfast. Okay. Sit down by the box. Isn't this magical? Our first breakfast in our new home. Yeah, I'm still a bit skeptical about this box, though. We can eat in style once the moving firm arrives with the furniture. Moving firm. But how was it? How was what, dear? Your first night in our new home. Did you sleep well? Well? Yeah. Fell asleep in my clothes. I noticed that, but I didn't have the heart to wake you up. Did you dream anything? I dreamt I was alone on a small island. What did you do? I dug a worm in the ground and used it as bait to catch a fish. Do you always dream about torturing small defenseless animals? Only in my good dreams. That's why I love you, I guess. I found a note in a fish. It's a treasure map. How exciting. Did you find the treasure? I was just about to, but then the alarm clock went off and the sun must have fused with my dream. That's when I woke up. It's strange how the mind incorporates real things into dreams like that. I read that it does that in order for us to get our precious rest no matter what. It only wakes you up if it thinks you're in danger. It's comforting to know that my mind is looking out for me even when I'm sleeping. But what do you think it means? What means? Your dream, silly. Someone's kind of weird about what they're asking. I don't know, what do you think? Well, do you want my appeasing bullshit answer, or do you want to know what I really think? I'll trust your judgment on this one. You can't be diplomatic in all situations, you know that, right? Well, no, I just want you to tell me what you think it means without any prior bias. In that case, I won't tell you. was just a dream, Alicia. You're taking it too seriously. I'm sorry, Victor. I guess the force of pregnant mood swings is with me today.
Don't I know it.
So how was your first night?
Slept quite well, actually.
Wow. You must have been dead tired, then.
Yeah, usually I can hardly sleep at all in unfamiliar places.
By the way, I also just noticed there's 4 radiators right in this corner of the room. Does it really need to be that warm?
Did you dream about anything?
I dreamt I was on a luxury cruise through the Mediterranean. I was on the deck in a fold-out chair being served umbrella drinks.
You've dreamt that before, haven't you?
Yeah, it's a recurring dream. It'll haunt me until the day you finally buy us that luxury cruise.
Haunt us both, then. Well, this is quite a breakfast. How long have you been up?
Since about 9, I think. I was having a dream, but after a while, it turned weird.
Yeah, you're telling me.
That's when I woke up.
What happened?
Well, do you remember the caretaker that let us in last night?
Yeah, can't remember his name though.
Me neither. Norton? Morton? Horton?
Something like that.
He was in my dream.
Sounds like he made quite an impression on you.
To be honest, he sort of creeped me out.
Well, I thought he seemed pretty nice.
He was nice in real life. The dream version of him was kind of creepy.
Hang on, I'm turning the sound volume down a little.
So what was so weird about your dream?
I don't want to talk about it, not while we're eating. It's a bit too graphic.
But what did the caretaker do in your dream?
Can't we talk about this later, Victor? I'm still a bit disturbed by it.
Speaking of the caretaker, he still has our key, doesn't he?
Yeah, he said he'd stop by with the duplicate this morning, but he must have forgotten.
I better call him then.
Sounds like a plan. I'll go wash the dishes while you give him a call.
You want me to help you with that?
Stop pampering me, dear. I'll be fine.
Hallway? Is that where? Oh, wait. Mail? Examine. Okay.
Dear Mr. and Miss Neff, thank you for choosing Prosser and Ankovich Realtor Service. We hope you enjoy your new home for many years to come. If you have any questions regarding our services, or if you have questions regarding the apartment or maintenance issues, please don't hesitate in directing them to our head office at this number, 555-497-680. We look forward to continuing to serve you. Again, I thank you for choosing Prosser and Ankovich.
Burping a bit tonight. Okay, that must be a light switch. Okay, nursery, bedroom. Where is there a phone?
Oh, here it is. Hello? Anyone there? I'm just gonna check if the furniture's arrived. Call the caretaker first. I don't want to be alone when he comes with the spare key. Yeah, sure thing. The movie's going. Okay, so now to find the phone. Oh god, I gotta check the boxes, don't I? That's not the right type of outlet. Okay. Maybe the bedroom has the right outlet? Not sure. It says baby clothes on the label. Okay, I'm a little lost right now. The view is so much nicer than the one in our old apartment. I'll miss the nature, though. Myself enough as it is. Kitchen? Maybe? That's not the right type of outlet. Where is the right type of outlet? And there's nothing in the fridge. Bathroom? Maybe? Don't know why it would be in the bathroom. Power. That's still not right. What is... examine the lamp. This must have belonged to the previous inhabitants. Doesn't work. Painting. That painting seems a lot like my dream. Must have fallen asleep looking at it. It has the kind of tacky charm that Alicia usually hates. I don't know where this thing is. Okay. Managed to get a hold of the caretaker? Found the phone, but I can't seem to find any outlet to put it in. Have you checked everywhere? I guess not. Maybe in the hallway? Hallway. Got it. Okay, move the box. Yes. There we go. Prosper Nankovich, how can I help you?
Yeah, hi, my name is Victor Neff. My wife and I moved into an apartment arranged by your company.
Why, hello, Mr. Neff. What can I do for you?
I'm trying to reach the caretaker of the building. You wouldn't happen to have his number, would you?
What's the address of the building?
I don't even know that. We just moved here yesterday. I can't recall.
Written down somewhere, yes. Okay. No. The envelope. There we go.
Call them again.
Professor Renankovich, how can I help you?
Yeah, hi, it's Victor Neff again.
I have another question for you.
Yes, how can I help you?
The caretaker's number. What's the address?
12 DuPont Crest.
That's the old building behind Esper Square, right?
I think so.
Yeah, we're new in town, so I don't know where everything is just yet.
Let's see here. I'm not finding any caretaker with that address.
You wouldn't happen to know his name, would you?
Crap.
I think it's Norton? Might have been. I was really tired last night, though.
No, I'm drawing a blank with Norton. Could it have been something else?
Horton?
Oh.
Sure sounded like it, but I wasn't really concentrating.
Nope, it must have been something else. There are no Hortons at that address. Could it have been something else?
He might have said Morton.
Morton, you say? I have a Felix Morton here, but he's actually listed as your landlord, not the caretaker. That's why I couldn't find him. Would you like his number instead?
Yeah, I suppose it must be the same guy.
Then his number is 555-647533.
Right. Got it.
Was there anything else you needed?
That's fine for now. Thanks for your help. Yeah, bye.
Phone call. Mr. Morton.
Morton here. Hello, this is Victor Neff from the second floor. The couple you let in yesterday.
Yes, hello, Mr. Neff. You settling in okay?
Everything's fine, thanks.
But I was just wondering when you'd be around to deliver the spare key you mentioned last night.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'd all but forgotten about that.
I figured you might have.
I'll be right up.
Thanks.
Okay.
Have you managed to get a hold of the caretaker? Yeah, I just got off the phone with him. We'll be right up with the keys.
Great. It'll be nice to have the keys to our own place.
Okay. You going out? I'm just gonna check if the furniture's arrived. Thought you said the caretaker was on his way out? I don't want to be alone when he comes with the spare key. What? Hang on. Oh, I used completely the wrong voice of that guy.
Hello again, Mr. Neff. Here's the spare key.
Thanks.
Do you find the apartment in order?
Yeah, everything seems fine. But I'll know more when we've had a chance to live here a bit longer.
Well, just tell me if you need help fixing anything. Is that all?
Yeah, I'm a bit confused as to what to call you. Are you the caretaker or the landlord? Yeah, the reason I'm asking is because Prosser and Ankovich didn't have you listed as the caretaker.
Yeah, I can see how that would be confusing. My family's owned the house for 4 generations. I rent out of the apartments I don't need and try to take care of the estate as best that I can, making me both the caretaker of the house and your landlord.
Yeah, I see.
Is there anything else?
Yeah, that's all for now.
Then I'll head off downstairs. Just give me a call if you need me.
Will do. Yeah, I could see how that guy could be a bit creepy.
Alright. Was that Mr. Morton I heard in the hallway?
Yeah, he was just here to drop off keys.
Did you get a creepy vibe off him?
Well, I can't say I did. Still seems quite nice to me.
I did.
Okay. So, continuing on. Now I'm gonna check if the furniture's here. The hell is...
Thought that might happen.
Oh no, wait, that's a different guy.
You're one of the new tenants, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right, I'm Victor Neff. My wife and I just moved in across the hall from you.
Why, hello there, young fella.
Oh.
I'm Edie Jones. I'm the resident senior in this house.
I couldn't tell. Seem to be having some problem with the elevator.
That door jams every once in a while. You'd be well advised to keep some sort of grease product handy to use on the hinges, you see. I'd lend you some butter, but I'm all out, I'm afraid.
That's okay. I'll probably be able to find something. Sorry if the sound disturbed you, ma'am. I'll leave you in peace. See you later then, Mrs. Jones.
Oh, just call me Edie. Everybody does.
Bye then, Edie.
Goodbye, dear.
Do we have anything? You know, I'm pretty sure butter on an elevator is probably... We don't have anything in here. God damn. Did you want anything? Maybe we'll go downstairs and see if the moving firm's arrived. Alright. Is the one door stairs? I think the one door stairs. Yeah. Oh, no, wait. Elevator's good. elevator's already here. Let me enter the elevator then. Why? What is going on right now? Go back into the house. Go back out again. There we go. What's with all the tape on these doors? Into the lobby. Yeah, I guess it's here. The sofa's blocking the entrance. Talk to the mover.
Are you Victor Neth?
Yeah, that's me.
We've got your sofa here, sir. Ready and delivered. So, if you'll just sign the receipt right here, I'll leave it in your hands.
You can't leave the sofa here.
It says nothing about an apartment delivery in the contract, sir. We deliver door to door, like it says right here.
You dick.
And technically speaking, this sofa has been delivered to a door.
God damn. I don't buy that. I think you managed to get our sofa stuck in the doorway. And since you can't get it free, you're just gonna leave it here.
You call it stuck, I say it's delivered. Sir.
Oh, man. Come on, help me out here.
Well, I guess I could give you this complimentary crowbar. I'm sure a big guy like you will be able to pry that sofa free in no time. Provided you sign the receipt, of course.
Oh, man. If I don't sign the receipt, I don't even get to try and do this. Fine, give it here, I'll sign the damn thing.
I'm glad you see reason, sir.
Hell, yeah, you sure as hell don't.
Here you go.
You haven't heard the last of this.
Signed and delivered. Personally, I consider this a job well done.
I'm sure you do. Seems to be permanently stuck. Hang on, I gotta get out of the way here. There's no way I'll get this sofa free. You're just gonna stand there?
Well, seeing as how I can't get out, I thought I might as well take a little break.
You're probably the laziest mover I've ever encountered.
Enjoy your sofa, sir.
I am tempted. But Alicia would be very upset with me.
Over what, sir?
Never mind.
So, my mailbox. I'm not here. Okay.
Just gonna stand there. Okay. Examine the sofa. Oh, Oh, wait, hang on. There's no way I'll get this over free. Yeah. Okay. I need to... Just come over to the hatch if you want to talk to me. Talk to Morton. Hello again, Mr. Neff. Do you require anything else? Like, my sofa is stuck in the entrance. Oh, I'm afraid my sciatica problems prohibit me from straining physical labor. Can't the moving firm help you out? Ah, that's the problem in the first place. I just dumped it here. I see. I wish I could help you more. They keep to themselves mostly. It's a quiet house, and that's the way I like it. Apart from you and me, there are three other inhabitants in the estate. On the top floor is Mr. Willard. He doesn't get out much due to his disability. Next to him lives Miss Theed. She works as a night nurse at the Abbey Hospital. She's asleep during the day, so I rarely see her. Next to you, we have Mrs. Jones, a widow since a few years back. And I'm afraid her age is starting to get the better of her. But on a good day, she's still quite lucid. She was pretty nice. What can you tell me about the estate? My great-grandfather used most of it for his research. He was one of the first to study and try to remedy sleeping disorders. Patients would live in wards upstairs while undergoing treatments. But as funding became an issue, he sectioned off more and more of it as apartments. In the end, this office and the back room was all that remained. So your family owns this building? That's right. My great-grandfather built this out back in the mid-19th century. It's gone from generation to generation since then. I'm the last in the line. Is there anything else? Nothing right now. I'm here if you need me. Okay. Okay, pick up the coat hanger. Okay. Just gonna sit there. Well, seeing as how I can't get out, I thought I might as well take a little lunch break. Probably the laziest mover I've ever encountered. Can I get that box off the sofa? But... I don't need to put it back. I'm hung enough already, thank you very much. It'll be fun to force him to swallow it. God damn, that's dark. But at least it wouldn't approve. Seems to be permanently stuck. Grate. I don't need to open it, and this hanger would be too flimsy if I did. I have a coat hanger now. I can't reach it. See, it's like, this looks like it might be able to open a little more. Maybe. Huh.
That's not how you use a crowbar.
There's no lock on the coat hanger.
I wonder.
And there's nothing in there. Hallway? Stairwell seems to be sealed off. Judging by the warning tape, I'd say it's probably hazardous. Second floor?
Why, hello again, Mr. Neff.
My sofa's stuck in the entrance. Don't suppose you could help me get it free?
I'm afraid I'm a bit too old for that sort of thing. Sound like that would most likely kill me outright.
Yeah, I was afraid you were gonna say that.
Did you say your name's Victor Neff? Like, the actor?
Yeah, like the actor. But he lived a bit before my time, though.
You two must be related, surely.
No relation, I'm afraid. Never seen any of his movies either, to be honest.
Ah, you're missing out then. He had a knack for playing brutes. He used to be a boxer, see, before he took up acting.
I assure you, our similarities end with our names.
Oh, you seem like such a polite young man. Unlike the caretaker here.
Mr. Morton?
Yes, that's the...
You don't like him?
How could I? He tried to get me evicted as soon as his father died. Fortunately, I've got connections with the housing board in this town.
What do you know about him?
Oh, about as much as I care to. I've lived here long enough to see him grow up. I knew his father quite well. He was the caretaker prior to little Felix. Wonderful man. Unfortunately, the apple fell far from the tree in this case. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm afraid I'm being rude to my guests. Game of bridge between three is, after all, not a game of bridge at all.
See you later then, Edie.
Goodbye, dear.
The door jam's been fixed already. Maybe tell my wife about it?
Did you want anything?
Those star movers managed to get the sofa stuck in the doorway.
Stuck how? You mean permanently?
It looks pretty bad. We might have to chop it up, I'm afraid.
But they'll reimburse us for sure, right? Seeing as it's their fault?
I wouldn't get my hopes up. They run a pretty shoddy operation.
Did you want anything?
No, never mind. Okay, let's try this again. God damn it. Door's locked. That's not what I meant to do. Okay. But downstairs? I'll be honest, I've got no idea. Seems to be permanently stuck. That would be a bad idea. He's clearly untrustworthy. What do I do?
Again, Mr. Neff, do you require anything else?
Nothing else right now. Yeah. Well, that must be the key to Mr. Morton's office. Okay. Third floor. I'd rather hold on to it. And that door's locked. That wouldn't be very polite. I don't want to upset our new neighbors. Yeah, stairwell. Okay.
Hello again, Mr. Neff.
Never mind. That's not the right key. Do I need to break the box? I don't want to get in there badly enough. I don't know how to pick locks. I'd estimate it has been about. Oh no, you know what? No. Call the realtor. Professor Renkovich, how can I help you? Yeah, hi, it's Victor Neff again. I have another question for you. Hi, how can we help you this time? The movers we employed managed to get a sofa stuck in the door.
I can assure you, they're not a firm we would recommend.
Look, could you help us out with that?
Of course, sir. Let me just check the schedule. Our earliest available slot is tomorrow afternoon.
Oh, but the sofa's blocking the entrance to the building.
I'm sorry, sir. I wish we could do more for you.
That's all, thanks.
No problem. Goodbye. You got anything?
No,
No.
Okay.
Switched over. I accidentally clicked into my Steam window. Okay. Work. Oh, damn. This has been really inconsistent, like, the whole time. Access to the basement seems to require a key. Let's just check. Gonna sit there. Well, seeing as I can't get out, I thought I might as well take a little lunch break. Probably the laziest mover I've ever encountered. Enjoy your sofa, sir. Okay. What if I tell this guy? It's gonna take a day.
Oh, again, Mr. Neff. Or anything else?
Nope, nothing. Seems to be permanently stuck. No way I'll get this sofa free.
Tampering with people's mail is illegal.
God. Okay. Maybe some people up here?
Set our new neighbors.
I don't want to get in there badly enough. See, if this was just my YouTube series, it wouldn't take me nearly this long. Favorite coat. She wore it on our first date. Oh.
Okay, so tomorrow afternoon is all they can tell me. Maybe go out a window? He's so much nicer than our old apartment. Yeah, whatever. I miss the nature, though. Dim the ashtray. Crumpled paper. Seems to be the remains of a letter. Somebody tried to destroy it, but the fire didn't consume it entirely. That should do it. What's this letter? Okay. So. Okay. The floorboard below the light switch in the bedroom. Okay. What is that talking about? Get somewhere there. Board is nailed to the floor. Can't get it up with my bare hands. Crowbar snapped in half. It's not even metal. Good thing I managed to get the board up before it broke. What the hell? Looks like this device measures the amount of current running through it. This device seems to be where the current ends up. I have no idea what it does.
Okay. Or is it still not working? Took a turn for the weird. Surfboard has a lot of little resistors on it, but I can't recall what a resistor does exactly. Does it increase or decrease the current running through it? Okay. I'd better not tamper with the fuse right now. Okay, so it's a... That's the current. Yeah, can we talk about what just happened there? What? What do you think of this note I found? Let me see. I think it might be a hoax. It sounds too good to be true, otherwise. Like something you'd read in a crime novel. Probably left us a present under the floorboards and wanted to rile us up a bit before we found it. Doesn't the fact that somebody's tried to destroy the note lend it some credence? Nah, he probably did it that himself to make it seem more mysterious. He seems to have made sure we can read the important parts at least. Either way, I think we should... I already checked. But someone at the...
Someone at the door?
Oh, right, because I hit the doorbell one more. Now I get to... Hang on, let me check the new stuff I got on Steam. Circuit path seems to have reset itself. Guess it's on a timer or something. Okay. Fuse is some kind of fuse. There's already a fuse in the socket. I'm getting really confused at what's going on here. Thank you.
is it coming from here? Alright, so... that way. Okay, so... We've lit the fuse. Probably designed to blow before anything else can happen. Maybe I can bypass it somehow. Like, with my key. Oh yeah. Fuse isn't useless now, I'll throw it away. It seems to have been too much power for the machine to handle. It's completely burned out. I wonder what it operated. What the hell? What was that? I thought I heard some kind of noise. I don't know, really. I did what it said on the note, and I found a circuit board under the floor. After I tampered with the circuit, the painting flew up.
What's that behind the painting, then?
I'm not sure.
It's a camera. So what is it?
Looks like a surveillance camera.
A camera? You mean someone was peeping on us while we slept?
Certainly seems that way.
Who would do such a thing?
I don't know. Maybe Mr. Morton? He had access to the apartment. He got a creepy vibe. Hold on. Crap, I can't save. I want to make sure he doesn't get away. I'll just go down and keep an eye on him until the police get here. I have to make sure he doesn't get away with this. I'll call the police in the meantime. This started slow and got really weird. Upstairs calling the police. He'll be here any minute. No. Moving right along, I guess. Alright. So. Anyway, I finished with one chapter, so. Gonna just put off continuing on till next time. So. These late night streams are going to be starting every Tuesday night, 10 p.m. Eastern. I was so caught up in... I was so caught up in trying to figure out that stupid thing, I didn't notice the chat. So... yeah. These streams are every week, Tuesday night, 10 p.m. Eastern. And I'm probably gonna just end them with some more of this. So. So, till next time. Again, we'll have a stream announcement video that'll be on my YouTube channel every Saturday. So, just keep watching, and it'll be good. So, till next time.